Everyone, and thank you for joining today's webinar. Today, we are presenting webinar on Be the CEO of Your Life, organized by Applied Science and Humanities Department of Parul Polytechnic Institute, Parul University. The main agenda of this webinar is to teach the ability for making important decisions in life and taking full responsibilities of our life and circumstances. I, Vaishali Nathwani, would like to introduce today's speaker. Today's speaker, intervention specialist, leadership coach and facilitator, Pooja Talesara Bhandari from Singapore. Pooja is an eager learner and a collaborator who is agile, passionate and creative in her approach. She believes her varied interest in spirituality, nature, cooking, dancing and writing poems. She has over a decade of rich and accomplished experience in human resources in the varied sectors globally. She was the first professional in family and youngest member in the senior leadership role for a leading global manufacturing organization. She is an internationally certified life and executive coach and is being mentored by John Matton, who is ex-Steve Jobs. She was awarded with the Sculpture Award. She was also nominated 6 times a LinkedIn Woman Wonder. She is also being recognized for her humanitarian work and conferred as Global Goodwill Ambassador. She has driven successfully many initiatives for the entrepreneurs, initiatives for women, executives and young leaders. Her coaches, who view her as a change agent who helps them to discover themselves and be better version of self that they can be, must be to achieve greatness in all space. It's a privilege to welcome you, ma'am.
Thank you. Namaste. Warm namaste to all of you. I hope you all are doing well. Thank you, Vaishali ji. Thank you, Hemal, for introducing me here. So today what I have planned for you is a bit of think shop. So what do I mean by think shop? Is we are going to work together. I'm going to present you an idea, a concept, and then I would invite you to work together. And then we may pick up one or two volunteers so that, you know, I could debrief. So that's the plan what I have. And I would look up for the help. Maybe from I know Hemal here, so I'll reach out to Hemal here, okay, for the help. And in case I need help in terms of, you know, in terms of more knowing who is going to participate from your end in terms of volunteer. All right, so that's what. Let's start. I'm going to show you my screen. Let me know if you can see my screen here. All right, I hope. Can all of you see my screen? Yeah?
Yes, madam. Yes.
All right, let's get started. So I'm going to start with a small story here. So there was this Liz Hurry, and she used to stay with her mother. She was in her mid-35. She was a very average-looking girl. Her life seemed very boring. That is, like, she felt it was very boring because very usual routine. In the morning, she has to get up, she has to go to her office, she has to come back. Nothing exciting happening. She didn't have many friends around, only she and her mom. So one day when she was on her way to her office, she saw a hat shop and she got very fascinated and she said, like, let me try this hat. So very hesitantly, she picked up one hat and she tried adjusting it. And someone nearby in that shop said, "Hey, you look so beautiful." And she felt really good. And then there was a small girl with her mother. The small girl said, "Mom, look at that lady. She looks so beautiful in that hat. I wish I had that hat." Liz was so happy about the hat. She went on to the counter. She paid the money. She again looked at the mirror and she started walking. So today was the first time when she felt like people were noticing her. As she entered in the lift, she felt like even in the lift, her colleagues were smiling. And her day was so fantastic, she felt at the workplace. So when she came back home, she told her mom, "Mom, you know what? Today's day was one of the best day in my life." And everyone around, I could feel like they were appreciating me. And as I was moving, everyone wanted to talk to me, "Mom. And this is all because of this hat." And mom said, "But which hat, Liz? I can't see." She said, "Are you serious? You can't see her hat?" She went hurriedly and she checked herself in the front of the mirror, and there was no hat. And then she tried to recall the incident, and she realized that while she paid for the money, she forgot to lift the hat. So the entire day, she thought she was beautiful was because of the hat. She felt people were noticing her because of the hat, though the hat was not there around. So you know why this happened? I would invite you all to think that, why do you think this happened? There was no hat. Okay, Liz was same, but still she felt, you know, people were looking at her differently. Now that is because of the alteration in her belief system. That's because of the alteration in her belief system. That's because of the alteration in the way she felt the people around her saw her. So when I speak about be the CEO of your life, three things. What I want you to focus is on your belief system. Just remember, we spoke about the Liz hat, right? So similarly, what is your belief system? Your belief system, what do you think about yourself, is so important, because that's going to determine your choice in life. Then once you have your belief system right, once your choice is right, you need to experiment it, because there's no foolproof in life. There's no foolproof. There's nothing like, you know, unless it's a chemical equation, but even coming to a chemical equation, a scientist may have to experiment a lot, right? So that's what the life is. Life is all about having the right belief system about yourself, choosing it, the power of choice, experimenting it. Then once you keep on experimenting it, you execute, and that's where you excel. Take example of great CEOs or the great leaders in the world, or even take, we're going to take different examples. Okay, let's say example of Mahatma Gandhiji. What got Mahatma Gandhiji on the way was, on the way of becoming a father of our nation, was the belief system, right? When he felt the belief system to be altered, that, you know, we deserve to be better, left. And then he made a choice of ahimsa. He kept on experimenting it. He executed it, and that's where he excelled. Example of Nelson Mandela, or you take example of Steve Jobs. When Steve Jobs was being thrown out of his organization, his own organization, it was his belief system. Example of even the Facebook CEO. I take example of any great leaders you would see. The belief system, choice, and then they experiment, execute, and excel. Now, what is one thing which is required? And this is a learner mindset. Because as I told you, life is not foolproof. You really don't know what's going to happen, right? It's just like, compare the analogy with the book. And the book, what do you know? The book, you know, what is the, when you're reading a book, there are few chapters which are so good and we don't want to move to the next chapter. Similarly, in life, there are a few moments which must be very good. Maybe when you, as a professor or as an educator, when you would have been received appreciations by your fraternity members or by your students, or when your work would have published, you would have felt like, wow, this is so beautiful. And there can be days when there is a low. So life is made of high and low both. But how do you move along this? That is determined by the power of choice. And that is what, for me, is being the CEO of your life. So be the CEO of your life equals power of choice. Now, I want to ask you, would anyone like to volunteer? What do you mean by BC and ACO? You know, you must have heard of before Christ and after Christ. But for me, BC is now, if you see at the moment, BCS before COVID and after COVID. Okay, so before COVID, the world was different, right? During COVID, we all find the world has become so different, and after COVID, the world would be different. But what do you think? What is a common thing in all those three things? There's still something common between before COVID, during the COVID period, and after the COVID period. What do you like to guess? What is something which is common before the COVID period, after the COVID period, during the COVID period? Would anyone like to volunteer and guess what is something which is common? There's still something which is very common. Would anyone like to guess? So that it can be more interactive session.
I think...
Yes?
We have right. learned online things that will be going on.
Okay. Let's try to think a little broader and wider.
Middle of the COVID. Because that common thing
is right. Okay, good attempt. Thank you. If you see before the COVID, after the COVID, during the COVID, one thing which is never going to change, be it in any period, is actually the way you look at yourself. As I tell you, like the COVID may have affected our net worth, but it can't affect our self-worth, okay? So if your self-worth is low, if you think about yourself very low, if you don't have your, if you don't believe in yourself, okay, then you will not succeed. There are still few people who are succeeding. So what is really common is you as a person and your choice. What things are you choosing is going to be the common and is going to define the life ahead. There are actually two kind of world we all stay within. So one is a real physical world. Now, what do I mean by real physical world? Sky is blue. Sky is blue, or you know, any such kind of factual thing which may be same for me, which may be same for you all, okay, at Parul University, maybe same for anyone else. So that is called a real physical world. Now, this is a perceived world. Now, what is a perceived world? Perceived world is which is something which is not same, which is different. I want you guys to understand this very, very well. Okay, this is the basis of our think shop today. Now, what do I mean by perceived world? Perceived world is like, I think, you know, I am not good. I think I'm not extrovert because that's what my friends tell me. Or, you know, I was not able to do good. Now, perceived world is there's something which is not factual. But you feel it to be true based on the other person's opinion. Now, you feel it to be true based on other person's opinion. Now, just imagine, based on the other person's opinion, you are deciding your own entire life. And then what happens is we get into the shell. We get into the shell and we feel like, no, I can never be good because they so-and-so said it, or because my past experience was that. So what I'm trying to say is you need to break the bubble of the perceived world of your past experiences. The past experiences which pull you, you need to break them because that's where the transformation begins. I'm going to again tell you a small story, okay? And I'm going to ask you to guess what I was trying to say here. So there were three monks. Were as well as good friend because they went into the monkship right at an early age, and there was a good kinship in them, good friendship, good bonding in them, in the monk. So now this three monks, they decided like from now onwards, we're going to meditate at a stretch. For 12 hours, and one of them would light the candle, and they will not speak while meditating. So now, when the first day went off very well, okay. On second day, the second monk was getting so restless. He couldn't just stop not seeing it because the candle was not light, which was the diya was not lit, okay, and which was the responsibility of the first monk. So the second monk, he got up and he said to the first monk, hey, you don't know you were supposed to light the diya and you have not lit. And, you know, how can we meditate? The third monk was smiling and he was saying, he told them, like, see, whatever happened, at least I didn't break my meditation and I was so focused on the meditation. So all three had decided that they will not break the meditation. They will not speak. But what happened in the second one? Second one felt so restless, okay, that this person has not done his duty. And so he broke his own meditation and as is the first one's meditation. Now the third one, the third monk, felt like, okay, these two people have broken, but see, I'm still in the solitude. I'm still in that meditation mode. And what happened? Even he broke off his, even he ended up breaking up his meditation because he went on to say. So in life, what happens? Sometimes we lose control of our life because we get into judgment. We get into the think like, this is not my responsibility. This was someone else's responsibility. We get into the comparison. And that's where we get off the line. Because being the CEO is what? You are being in charge. You are being in control of your thoughts, of your action, of your vision. And when is it possible? It's possible only when you are in integration, when you are in complete control of your vision, of your integration, of your heart, and what actions you want to take. So that's what I call it as a two mindset. So I want all of you to note down in your paper and pen in your own place, wherever you can, that which mindset do you have right now? Is it a carpenter mindset or the gardener mindset? Now, what do I mean by the carpenter mindset? Carpenter mindset is about you worrying. It's continuously worrying. It's very judgmental. Okay? It's full of guilt, shame, doubt. Okay, it's continuously comparing and complaining. They would criticize. They would shy away. They don't want to take responsibility. Now, if you see the three monk, what happened? The second monk started worrying, right? He started putting, the third monk was judgmental here. And the first monk, he went into the guilt, shame, and again, he broke his, that he didn't have to speak. He had to go silent. It was continuously comparing and complaining, criticizing happening. Just imagine the second monk would have got up, or the third monk have gotten up and would have lit the candle. None meditation or the silence woe would have been broken, right? But what happens is they went to the carpenter. So what is a carpenter? They have a design, right? And then they tried. What is the carpenter does, right? He has a design in mind and then he tries to make in that design. That's what this the gardener does. In a garden, each flower, each plant has a different life cycle, right? But the gardener is every day very patiently watering them, trying to give them as per their needs. So a gardener mindset is of a warrior mindset. Think about the plants. You know, sometimes the plants are not growing well, then he gives fertilizer or something. So what is a warrior mindset? That you keep on analyzing and you feel like, hey, I'm not going to give up. I'm still in charge. I'm going to try. I'm going to move forward. I'm going to learn from my mistakes. I will keep on improving. I want to be the better version of myself each day. I'm not going to compare with others, right? So you have different plants. Now, there are few plants which grow well in sight, right? Indoor. And there are few plants which grow well outdoor. There are few plants which need a lot of sunlight. Each one's and everyone's requirement, life cycle is different. So are we. We all are at a different life cycle point. But then what does it mean? Are we not doing well? I want to ask you all, you are educators. Tell me a person who has got a PhD, a degree, even at the age of 23, let's say 23, 24, and at the age of 45, still he would be called as a doctorate, right? A person who has got his business starting at the age of 25 or at the age of 60, you'll still be called as a businessman. So each one of us has our own life cycle, has our own timing, just like the plant. So don't compare yourself and get upset seeing others. But you need to be a comparer. You need to compete with yourself. Like what you are today, strive tomorrow to be the better version of yourself. Your life needs to be a purpose driven. And that's where you will have a control of your life. Just the way Mahatma Gandhiji's life became very purpose driven. Just the way Dhirubhai Ambani's life became very purpose driven. If you see, there was a transformation point even in the Microsoft CEO. Earlier, he was not very philanthropist. But then there was a time which changed him, just like King Ashoka, okay? King Ashoka, we all know the story of King Ashoka, right? There was a point in his life which changed him, which transformed him when he went in the search of what the real world is about, right? When he broke that burst of what other people think of him or why he wants to be that. When he moved from the carpenter mindset to the gardener mindset, his life became purpose-driven. He started taking accountability, all right? So I want you to write, I want each one of you to write that which mindset are you right now? Which mindset are you right now? Are you in a carpenter mindset or a gardener mindset? Can you all write, please, in your notepad or whatever you have? Which mindset are you right now? Gardener mindset or a carpenter mindset? Then we could have a couple of volunteers sharing. Yeah, who would like to share? Gardner mindset. Thank you. Excellent. Yeah, I think we have around, I can see 6 participants here. Who else would like to share? Come on. I want all of us to benefit from this think shop. So please do share. Which mindset do you feel you are right now, carpenter or a gardener mindset? People who have said you are in a gardener mindset, I want you to, you know, to rate yourself on the scale of 1 to 5. Do you compare yourself with others? Do you complain? Do you criticize? On the scale of 1 to 5, 1 being the lowest, 5 being the highest. Do you take accountability? Do you take initiative or you wait for someone else to give you that opportunity? Or you would go ahead and take an opportunity? Okay, so think about this. All right, I'm trying to read the comments. All right, Gardner mindset, 3rd. All right, excellent. What about others? What about Vaishali? What do you think? Which mindset you are, Vaishali? What about Jeevdeen? What about Brijesh? Please note down which mindset you think you are, gardener or carpenter mindset. It's very important, guys. All right, excellent. All right, let's start. Let's continue. So till now, what we have covered is what is being the CEO of your life. So you can write in your own notepad that what does being the CEO of your life mean for you? Okay. Then I want you to write down what mindset you are. You're in a carpenter mindset or the gardener mindset. I'll give you an example. So the CEO of JP Morgan, okay, Damon. So he was earlier within organization, KPMG, and wherein he was then asked to leave. And then suddenly just imagine he was working every day so much. And just imagine from 72 hours of work, his work getting reduced to 0 hours. Okay, it was so difficult for him to get back to work. And that's when many people asked him, that how are you feeling now? And that's where he said that this whole transition would have taken away my net worth, but it can't take my self worth. Okay, so if you're of a gardener mindset, you will be always in control. You will always feel like a captain of a ship. And you will be always be ready to be in charge of your life, and you will be able to move ahead. Rather than, even if we fail, it is important to fail forward. What do I mean by fail forward? There would be problems. There would be things in our life which may trouble us. We may feel like this is not happening as for me. But we need to fail forward. Okay, fail forward is learn from your mistakes. So I say, like, you know, follow the example of follow this triangle, rather, that whenever there is a failure, first thing what you need to do is you need to accept it. Okay, fine, this is happening to me. Acknowledge the feeling. Okay, after acceptance, acknowledging the feeling, how are you feeling, then try to make an advancement. Ask yourself those three questions. What have I learned from this? What am I going to do differently next time? What is something which is going to, which helped me to overcome this phase? Okay, so I wanted to think, all of you, to think about one, I call it as a one bumpy ride rather than a failure, one ride which was towards the lower side in life. So I want you to think that what is one learning experience of failure, okay? What is one learning experience you have had? I call failures as a learning experience. I want you to think that, what did you learn from it? What would you do differently next time? Have you accepted it, or is it somewhere making you into the guilt, shame, or doubt? Can you all write it down, please? What is one failure which you feel you have had in life, which are you still in a guilt, shame, or doubt about yourself? What is something which you have learned from it, and how are you going to, or what you are going to do differently next time when you face the same thing? Can we all write this? Can we all write this? Okay. What is one failure we have had in the life? Okay. Research. All right. So what are you going to do? Okay. So are you still in the, when you say research, then are you still in the shame, or are you still in the guilt, or is it stopping you to try things, or are you going to try things again? So I want you to think that, what is stopping you to try again? What have you learned? If there is a failure in research, but what have you learned from it? The failures are meaningful only and only when we learn from them. So I want you to write it down. What have you learned from it? What would you do differently? Would anyone like to share this? Would anyone like to share? What would you do differently next time? Or probably you could just write it down. All right. So, these are the 5 S we need to follow. That whenever there is something which is not going right in our life, we need to scan. Why is it not going right? What is something? Is it because of my belief system? Or is it because of my actions? Or is it because I don't have enough skill set? Okay. 3 things. Is it because of my belief system? Is it because of my actions that I'm not taking actions? I'm not even working hard? Or is it belief system that I'm thinking like I can't do, or I'm thinking too much about what other people are saying about it? Or is it that I don't have the right skill set for it? Okay. So the transformation begins when you need to scan. Scan 3 things. Okay. Is it your belief system which is stopping you? Is it the skill set which is stopping you? Okay. Or is it that you think, when you think about your belief system, that you're not good enough? Or is it the skill set? What is really stopping you? You need to scan through it. Okay. Once you have scanned through it, that what is it? Is it a belief system? Or is it your skill set? Or is it your heart or interest is not there? What is something that is stopping you? What is something which is stopping you to be the best version of yourself? Once you have scanned, then you need to pick it up and you need to stop doing that. Okay? You need to figure out that, if you want to be a great research. Surround yourself, okay? Surround yourself with the people who are great researchers. Surround yourself with the people who are very curious, very inquisitive. Devote every day 1 hour to what you want to become. Test your belief system. That what is your belief system? Is it something which is stopping you, which is pulling you? You need to scan the pattern. You need to stop it. After stopping the pattern, okay, the pattern what you have been following. See, our life is based on pattern, okay? I do so much of coaching work, even with the CEOs, with the corporate leaders, and I always, always tell them that our life is based on pattern. So you need to scan the pattern, okay? Because till the time you don't learn a lesson, the patterns will keep on repeating. We call it as, it's going to be very repeated, okay? So scan, stop, and sketch. Now, what do I mean by sketch? Sketch is like, how do you envision yourself? Do you envision yourself to be a great researcher? How are you going to go? What kind of researcher do you want? Okay, so you need to sketch. Okay, so scan. What is stopping you from achieving what you want to be? Is it coming from yourself, or is it coming from your environment, or is it coming from the skill set? After that, scanning, you need to stop. Okay, something which is not working out, we need to stop. Now, what has happened is this is what we have created that burst in the cycle. After that, you need to sketch, you need to think, you need to envision what you want to be. And after envisioning, you need to make a switch to the new person you want to be. When you make a switch, it is very, very uncomfortable because you're moving out of your comfort zone. Okay? So can you all, you know, anything which you have highlighted, something which is not working in your life, can you scan that? Why is it not working well? Is it because of yourself, or is it because of the people around you? Why is it not working well? Scan it. Can you all scan it? Can you all write it down? Why is it not working well? Can you all do that? Okay, I'll give you less than a minute. I want all of you to write it down. Why is it not working? I want you to scan that whatever you want it to be. If you want it to be great at research, why it happened so? Okay, scan. After you scan, you need to stop. And then you sketch out that what kind of research you want to do, what kind of a research person you want to be identified as. And then you need to make a switch that what is the old you? Okay, what is the old you and what is going to be your new version? The version 2. Okay, how are you going to make that shift? Maybe you may have to manage your time. Okay, then you need to have a time management as a habit. Or maybe you need to read a lot. Okay, what is it going to require you to reach that? So remember, we spoke about scan, stop, okay? Scan, what is not working well, you need to stop it. Okay, scan, stop, and you are going to sketch. What do you want to do? Okay, and after sketch, what do we do? What is the fourth one? Anyone? Scan, stop, sketch. How to use technology and learning resources online, version 2. Very good, excellent, superb. Superb, very good, very good point, Himal, excellent. So that's what now you have to see. How are you going to use the technology and learning resources online? If that's your version 2, if that's where you're going to move, then maybe what you can do is look out for the online resources. Look out for the online resources and try yourself to deliver it, okay? Have a protocol that when I go online, these are the things which I may require. What kind of audience am I engaging with? Okay, so you need to have all those studies done, and that's where you need to switch, right? You are going to switch from the traditional pattern of teaching to now online, right? Excellent. Are we going so far okay? Give me a thumbs up or let me know how are we going so far. Okay, the speed, are you understanding the concepts? Yeah? All right, excellent. All right, so I'm going to just brief you till now what we did. We started with what is being the CEO of your life, Okay, we started, what is being the CEO of your life? It is a lot to do with your beliefs, with your choices, and the way you experiment, you execute. Okay, you experiment, you execute, and you excel. Okay, so when you're excelling at something, it requires a lot of right habits, empowering belief system. And that's what the CEO of life is. CEO of life is when you're in full control of yourself. Okay. Then we discussed about the carpenter mindset, gardener mindset. Then I gave you a powerful tool of 4S. Okay. Can, stop. Then you need to sketch, and then you need to switch on to the new version. Okay. So this is what we covered so far. All right. Now I want you to, all right. Now I want you to think of this car. Okay, look, take a look at this car, okay? And write down which part of the car do you think you are. Okay, I want you to look at the car, or you can look at any, you must be knowing different parts of the car, okay? So I want you to write down which part of the car do you think you are, which part of the car you want to become, okay? Which part of the car you think you are, which part of the car you want to become, which part of the car do you think your family or your colleagues think of you to be. Can we all do this? Okay. Look at the picture of the car. I want you to write down which part of the car do you think you are, which part of the car you want to become, which part of the car do you think your friends, your colleagues, your family people think of you to be? Okay, I want you to write down which part of the car you think you are, which part of the car your family, your friends, your colleagues think of you to be, and which part of the car you want to become. Can we all write it down? Okay, I'll tell you why. Please write it down. Which part of the car you think you are, which part of the car your friends, colleagues, family members, you think, you know, they're thinking of you to be, and which part of the car you want to be. I want one volunteer. Can I have one volunteer for this exercise, please? Any one volunteer who would like to do this exercise with me? Okay, Himal, you think you are a volunteer. Colleagues think of you to be a mirror, okay? And which part of the car you want to be, Hamil? Which part of wheel. The car you want to be? Yes.
Wheel, madam. Wheel.
You want to be a wheel. And yes. Which part of the car you think you are right now?
Same, madam.
Same? Okay. Yes. And which part of the car do you think your colleagues think of you to be? Mirror. Right? So yes. Why do you think you are a wheel?
Because at present, madam, as the portfolio that will be given, so on that basis, I'm capable to be a strong. So wheel that will take all the hardness of car. So that is why that word that is, I think, relate to me.
Okay, so if you need to give me one key sentence, one key word rather, why do you think you are wheel? What is one key word? It is because that you are taking everyone along with you. Is it because of that?
It's a performance.
Okay, performance. Okay, and why do you think your family people think of, your colleagues think of you to be a mirror?
Because whenever we are working
see,
together.
What Hemal, what did you say? Why are they thinking you whenever, to be a mirror? Yeah?
Because whenever we are working together, so some difficulty level is there. So each one will face a different difficulty level. So different types of work we are doing here. So as we have organized webinar online, so how to conduct a webinar and how to communicate with speaker, that is one convince to the speaker and give 50 minute talk. So that is one difficult for us to convince the speaker.
No, so why do you think you are a mirror is my question.
My colleague, that is a mirror, madam. So
no, my question is, Hemal, what does your colleague think of you to be? You are thinking that you are a wheel, but what does your colleague, what does your friend or a family member think of you to be? Which part of the car do they think of you to be?
Well, he is a wheel of our department. As he is the head of the department, and he always, though the hardness or the toughness comes in the life, he goes on, he never stops and faces all the challenges and goes on silently. He is a silent person of our department, and still he will always carry a smile on his face, and he will never give up, whatever the phase of the life it is.
He'll never give up. So it is his ability to keep on moving ahead, his ability to be accountable of one's life, is it?
Yes,
and being
yes.
helpful. Am I right, Vaishali, in my understanding?
Yes.
Yeah? So why are we doing this? And what do you think, Vaishali? Which part of the car do you think yourself to be?
Okay. I have to think for you, ma'am, because I just forgot the picture that you shared with us, other parts of the car.
Yeah, so you think yourself to be what, sorry, Vaishali?
Ma'am, I have to just see the picture again of the
car. Yeah, just look at the picture. I mean, just imagine the picture in your mind. Do you think yourself to be a steering wheel? Do you think yourself to be a gear, front door, back door, or a trunk? Or engine, or headlight. What do you think?
I think engine.
True, madam. That is true, madam.
See, it is so difficult for us, right? So this is a very powerful exercise. See, you remember what I told you. Being the CEO of your life is. Now, the moment Vaishali was very open to say about Hemal, right? About how Hemal is. But the moment when I asked about Vaishali, she went a little bit in thoughts, okay? So that's what being the CEO of your life is. When our awareness about ourselves is very high and we are able to communicate, we are able to believe. We are able to believe ourselves and we know a better understanding, okay? So let's do in this example. Hemal, what do you think? Are you okay, Vaishali, if I ask Hemal?
Sure,
ma'am. No issues. Yeah. So, Hemal, what do you think? Which part of the car do you think Vaishali is?
True, madam. As madam have said, engine, that is best part from the car.
Mm-hmm. And because, why do you think she is an engine?
Because at present, we are 7 in number. Our department will have 7 faculties are there. But from the 7... the madam is always with us, and personally I have said with me, because whenever we are doing some going through some difficult work, or so first I have discussed with Vaishali madam, and then after discussion of that some conclusion is there and we move forward.
Okay, so see, Vaishali, do you think you are an engineer?
I think so, ma'am.
See, okay, so that's why we did this exercise. Okay, it's very important to understand which part of the car you think and which part of the car your colleague, your friend, your family member think of you and why. Okay, Vaishali, which part of the car you want to be?
I think I'm comfortable with engine.
You're comfortable with engine. Why not? Why you don't want to be a steering wheel, or why you don't want to be a headlight or an antenna?
Mm-hmm. because for steering wheel, I think that that must be my pressure on us, and I don't want to handle some pressures on my side, right?
So now listen, whenever you want growth in your life, okay, you have to move a little, okay? We have to move a little in the uncomfortable zone. So I have given you today all very powerful tool, which I do with the CEOs, okay? In my one-day workshop, I have just tried to condense it, okay? So whenever you feel that you feel you are stuck or something, think about this. Which part of God in this situation I think myself to be? Which, let's say there's a situation wherein you want to move country, okay? Wherein you want to, you have been assigned a high resource work, and you're not very sure about it. You have to think, which part of the car do I think in this situation I am? Why? Which part of the car I want to be? Why? Which part of the car I think my boss or my colleague thinks of me to be in this situation? Why? The moment you think this, it's going to help you to move forward, because you will get into a transformation zone, right? For example, now for Vaishali, she thought through and she said, I don't want to be in the pressure. You know, I don't want to take on the pressure. Okay, so it will help you, like, what are the things which are stopping you, which are pushing you and which are pulling you. Okay, it helps you to identify in the life push and pull, which is so, so important. Does it make sense, Vaishali, Hemal, Jitin, and others? Are we okay?
Yes.
Yeah?
Yes.
All right.
Yes.
So, I'm giving you today, I'm giving you four powerful tools, okay? The first tool what I gave you was about the carpenter and the gardener mindset. The second one I gave you was about the 4X we spoke about. Now, the third one I've given you is when you're faced in any situation, okay, how can you navigate through that difficult situation? I gave you a mirroring example, okay? You remember the hat, what we spoke about? Yeah? So this will help you to identify which hat is more comfortable for you, okay? Now, the last one, what I want to tell you for today's think shop is that whenever we are in any problem, okay, think of two circles, okay? One is a circle of control and one is a circle of concern. Now, what is circle of control? Things which are in our control. Now, what is in our control? Our actions, our thoughts, our behavior, it's in our control. What is outside our control? Outside our control is what's going to happen, what other people are saying, the nature. It's all is outside our control. We don't have control over it, okay? Directly, we don't have any control over it. For example, control over it? No, we didn't have any control over it. So we can keep on crying and we can be upset about it. Our second thing, what we can do is we can focus on things which are in our control. What is in our control? To ensure that our health is safe, to ensure that we use all the safety precautionary methods, that all is in our control, right? Let's say if you're switching to the online learning zone, what is not in your control? It is not in your control that how the technology will behave at that moment. Would the Wi-Fi be high or no? Okay, it's not in your control that would children be completely engaged in your listening or not. You really don't know. But what is in your control? Can you do your research well so that it keeps the children engaged? Can you ensure that you have done a checkup of all the system in place so that you have a smooth delivery? So what happens is most of the time we spend in the things which are outside our control, in the circle of concern. And what happens? Then we are down with stress, anxiety. We feel there's so much of pressure. We don't want to do those things. We want to run away. We become in a fight or a flight syndrome. I want you to move from the circle of concern, things which are not in our control, two circle of control, things which are in our control, okay? Then there are sometimes when you need to influence other, you need to work in coordination with others. So in life, your circle of control should be bigger, okay? Then it should be circle of influence, and in terms of the big, it should be circle of control. The smallest should be circle of concern, because it's others, it's not in your control. What is in your control is you yourself, not the people who are not CEO of their life, who are the people who have come, who waste their time thinking about the things which are not in their control, being upset, being in the worry mindset. And what does the CEO do? CEO of life is continuously deciding, is continuously preparing for the things which are in their control. They are continuously upskilling themselves for the things which are in their control. So be it Gulf War, be it 9/11, or today be it COVID, or be it influenza. Okay, each incident in life, okay, has taught us that the one who is the CEO of their life, the one who is able to understand things which are in their control, things which are outside their control, one who is able to stop, is able to scan, stop, and switch over, one who is able to leverage the Gardner mindset is going to be the CEO of your life. Now, why is it important to be CEO of your life? It is important so that you are stress-free. It is important so that you have clear vision. You are very purpose-driven and you inspire people around you. Okay, you are educators. You want to inspire people. You can only inspire us once you are in control of your life. Okay, once you are in charge of your life. If you think, what do you think? The great people in their life, they have never had their failures, they have never had difficulties, they have had difficulties, they have had their own share of failures, but they have failed forward, they have learned. They look at it everything as an experiment. So it's very important, because it's nothing about starting all over again in life. Remember that. It's nothing about starting all over again in life. It is always that, we have learned on some skill sets, and we are just continuously leveraging those skill sets. Okay. Now, at last, what I want you to do is, I want you to write down from today onwards, what are the things that you will stop doing? What are the things that you'll start doing? What is one learning from the session today? Okay. Can you all write down from today onwards, what are the things which you will stop doing? Start doing? What is one learning today from the session? Can you all please do that? Talk, stop, and what is one learning from today's session? This is my favorite thing. Let me read out for you. You are the CEO of your life, the captain of your ship. You set the path, purpose, and pace. Okay, so you are the CEO of your life. You have that power. Okay, we have the power of choice. We don't know what's going to happen tomorrow. We can't change what has already happened, but we can little bit write the story differently if we exercise our power of choice, if we exercise the power of now, if we leverage on this power of being the CEO of your life. Okay, a little bit about my organization and what we do. We do a lot of webinars, we do consulting and coaching. We do workshops for the educators. We run a personal leadership program. Then we run a program for the children, for the students, which is in collaboration of Washington University. So that's what we do. And this is my favorite quotation. Let me read out for you. Ability is what you are capable of doing. Motivation determines what you do. Attitude determines how well you do it. Okay, so attitude is going to determine how well you do it. So it is very important to be careful of what kind of attitude are you wearing. How are you you know, moving forward in the life, be careful that what kind of people have you surrounded yourself with. Okay, I'm going to leave it open now for any questions you have right now for me. Another 5 minutes, I'm going to leave it open there.
Thank you. What a wonderful session. One question is then how to make major decisions in life with calm mind.
Okay, beautiful. Very powerful question. Now, first of all, I'm going to give you two techniques here. Our life is based on pattern. So first of all, you need to understand your pattern. Okay, what happens is, now tell me, whoever has asked this question, tell me, when there is a fire in the house, okay, when there's a fire in the house, what will you do? You will break the fire alarm there and you will go off to sleep, or you will recognize the fire alarm, right? You will recognize the fire alarm. So what happens is, whenever there is a problem, that's the time when we want to really, you know, think about it. How about thinking it before? Understanding your pattern of life. So you should write down that what is the best decision in your life? What is the worst decision in your life you have made? Okay? When you have made the best decision, they were your best decision because you made it, you know, by your head, by your heart, or by listening to others. And if it was your worst decision, why they were worst decision? Because you listened to someone or you didn't listen to someone. You did your research, you didn't do your research. How were you feeling at each point of time? So you will have your pattern identified. So next time when you're making your decision, just replicate that. That's one way. Second way, very powerful way, is understand whenever you're making a decision, try and think what is in your control, what is outside your control, okay? Circle of concerns, circle of control, and then go ahead and make a decision. And first of all, to calm your mind, it is very important that tackle all your 5 senses, okay? Because even when you meditate, you close your eyes and you meditate, right? So tackle all your 5 senses. Maybe I do this thing of 5-4-3-2-1 in my workshop. 5-4-3-2-1 is a mindfulness, okay? So try to see what are the 5 things which you can see around which you can't touch, okay? What are the 3 things, the sound which you can hear? What are 3 things sound you can hear? What is something which you can smell? What is something which you can taste, okay? Bring your awareness there and then make a decision with deep breath, okay? So these are 3 techniques. I hope it helps.
Yes. And how to implement this decision, ma'am?
How to implement a decision. Now, how to implement a decision, you have to think that what is really stopping you to implement, okay? If something is stopping you to implement, it is maybe because your belief system, you have too much of doubt about yourself, or too much of, you're too scared about the consequences, okay? So always remember, there is nothing which is foolproof. It is all about experimenting, okay? So don't be harsh on yourself. But definitely don't go and implement very blindly. Figure out the pros and cons. But it has a lot to do with your belief system.
Great, ma'am. Thank you. We have covered all the questions. And thank you so much for giving us your valuable time.
Thank you. Absolute pleasure. Thank you so much. I hope the session was useful.
Yes, ma'am. It was a very interactive session. I would like to thank you, the head of our department, Mr. Hemal Patel, sir, the HI of our institute, Professor Jatin Vaitya, sir, the academic director, Dr. Mahesh Bhatt, sir, and president of our university, Dr. Devanshu Patel, sir, for motivating and supporting us continuously. Last but not the least, I would like to thank you all who have assembled here today for this beautiful webinar. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Stay blessed and stay safe. Really humbled. All right. Thank you so much.
Thank you, madam.
Thank you. All right. I can log off?
Yes.
All right. Thank you.